Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 in Imperial.
Now go to the Home tab and Layer panel and select the Make Current command. Select the cabbage layer to make it the current layer. Now go to the Home tab, Draw panel and start the Line command. At the specified first point prompt, click at this endpoint. At the specified next point prompt, move the mouse cursor and click to this area and this area. Press enter to end the command. Now, go to the Home tab, Layer panel and select the Isolate command. Select one of the objects in the cabbage layer and press enter. AutoCAD hide all the other objects except the objects that are in the cabbage layer. To grid the Fisher board, go and hover your mouse cursor to the UCS and right click. In the menu that appears, select the object option and select this line. AutoCAD move the UCS into that line. Now right click the UCS again and select the rotate axis option. Select the X axis. Now turn on your oval mode and rotate the X and Y plan into this direction by moving the mouse cursor in the up direction. Now the Y axis points in the up direction and the Z axis points in the other direction. Now go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the Offset command. For the offset distance, type 1 foot and press enter. Select this line and move down and click. Oops. Select this line, hold down your Control key on your keyboard and type the number 1 key. As you can see, this line is a 3D polysolid, so you cannot offset a 3D polysolid. So all we need to do, we're going to erase this line and change it to the normal 2D polyline. Press Escape. Now go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the Offset command. For the offset distance, type 1 foot on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it down. Now also got offset the line down 1 foot. Select these two objects and right click into the drawing area, isolate object. AutoCAD hide all the other objects except these two objects. Use the polyline command again. At the specified start point prompt, start from this area and move the line to the end point of this other line. Press Escape to get out of the command. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel and click the down arrow next to Modify. Select the Break command. Select this line and select it again. AutoCAD divide this line into two parts. Now go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the Fillet command. Fillet this line to this line. Start. Press enter to start the Fillet command again. Fillet this line into this line. Now type join on your keyboard and press enter. Select all this line, press enter. AutoCAD convert this line into polyline. Now right click into the drawing area, isolate end object isolation. AutoCAD bring back the object that you hid recently. Now select this profile, go to the Home tab, Modeling panel and select the Extrude command. Extrude, move your mouse cursor into this direction and type 1 inch on your keyboard, press enter. Hover your mouse cursor to the UCS again and right click. In the pop-up menu that appears, select the Object option. At the prompt, select Objects to align the UCS. Select this object. Now right click, hover your mouse cursor to the UCS again and right click and select the rotate axis. Select the X option and rotate the Y, X and Y plan parallel to the gable roof. Now go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the Offset command. For the offset distance, type 1 foot and press enter. Select this line and offset it down. Again, this line is a 3D polyline. Now select this line and erase it. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel and select the 2D polyline command. At the specified start point prompt, click at this corner. At the specified next point prompt, click at the end point of this line. At the specified next point prompt, click press enter to end the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 1 foot on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it down. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the trim command. Press enter, trim off the line that you just offset. Press escape. Select the polyline command again. At the specified start point from, start from this corner to this end point of this the offset line. Press enter. Press enter again to start the polyline command. Start from this corner to this corner. Press enter. Now select this line and this line. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, hide objects. Now select this line, and this line. Type join on your keyboard and press enter. AutoCAD join this line into one solid line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the extrude command. At the select object to extrude prompt, select this closed polyline and press enter. Now move your mouse cursor inside and type 1 inch on your keyboard. Press enter. AutoCAD extrude the line inside. Select this line and hit the delete key on your keyboard. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the polyline command. At the specified start point prompt, click on this corner. At the specified next point prompt, click at the end point of this line. At the specified next point prompt, click. Press escape to get out of the command. Now hover your mouse cursor to the UCS and right click the UCS. Now select the option origin. This allows you to move the origin of the UCS. Move the origin and click at the end point or the midpoint of this line. AutoCAD move the UCS in this area. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. AutoCAD still remember the 1 foot distance that you enter. So if yours is not 1 foot, enter 1 foot on your keyboard and press enter. Then offset this line down. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the 2D polyline. At the specified start point prompt, click at this corner. At the specified next point prompt, click at this intersection. Press escape. Press the spacebar to start the command again. At the specified start point prompt, click at this corner. At the specified next point prompt, click at this intersection. Press escape to cancel out of the command. Now select the vertical and horizontal line. Right click into the drawing area. Hover the mouse cursor to isolate and hide objects. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. At the select first object prompt, type R and press enter for the radius option, and type 0 for the distance. Type M for multiple option and press enter. Now select this line and fillet it to this line. Select this line, fillet it to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Now type join on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line, press enter. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Select this profile and press enter. Now move your mouse cursor inside the model and type 1 inch on your keyboard. Press enter to get out of the command. Hover your mouse cursor to the UCS and right click and select the object option. Select this line. Now hover the mouse cursor to the UCS again, right click and select the rotate axis. Select the X option. Move the mouse cursor to the Z direction so that now the Y axis is pointing in the Z direction. Turn on your auto mode if your auto mode is off and click. The X and Y plan rotates into a new orientation. Now go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the 2D polyline. At the specified start point, click here at a specified next point undo, use the endpoint of this line. At a specified next point undo, use the other endpoint of this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 1 foot and press enter. Offset this line down. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the 2D polyline command. At a specified start point, start from this corner and move your mouse cursor to this corner. Press enter to end the command. Press enter again. Start from this point to this point. Press enter to end the command. Now select the long line and the vertical line. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, hide objects. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. AutoCAD still remember the previous radius that she used, so type M for multiple option and press enter. Fillet this line to this line, this line to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Type join on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line, press enter. AutoCAD convert the polylines into one polyline. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the extrude command. Select this line and press enter. Now move your mouse cursor inside, type 1 inch and press enter. AutoCAD extrude this object inside. Select, right click on the UCS and select the object option. Select this line. Now right click on the UCS again. Select the rotate axis and select the X axis. Move your mouse to the Z direction. Now the Y is pointing into the Z direction. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset corner. For the offset distance, type 1 foot. At the select object point, select this line and move down. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the 2D polyline command. At the specified first point point, start from this corner, then move your mouse cursor to this intersection. Press escape. Start the line command, polyline command again. Start from this endpoint and move to this intersection. Press escape to get out of the command. Now zoom in into this area. Select this object by using the crossing window. Right click, isolate object, hide object. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Type M for the multiple option. AutoCAD still remember the previous radius that you used. Select this line, this line, this line, this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Now type join on your keyboard and press enter. Select this object and press enter. AutoCAD join this object into our object. Select the extrude command. Now select this object and press enter. Move into the internal part and type 1, press enter. AutoCAD extrude this line inside. Now go to the home tab, layer panel, and click layer properties manager. This will bring the layer properties manager. Click the new layer icon. Create a new layer named Fisherboard. And change its color to, in this color, 255. Click OK. Click OK to close the layer properties manager. Now select the Fisher boards. Go to the layer panel and change, move it to the Fisher board layer. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this object. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. At the prompt specifying base point, click on this area. At the specifying second point, or use first point as a displacement, type 5 inches and press enter. Select this solid, go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. At the specifying base point point, click in this area. Now move the mouse cursor inside and type 5 inches, press enter. Press enter again to start the command. Select this and press enter. At the specifying base point prompt, click here for the base point. Move the mouse cursor inside and type 5 inches. Press enter. Press enter to repeat the command again. Select this object and press enter. At the specifying base point prompt, click in this area. Now move the mouse cursor inside, type 5 inches and press enter. Press enter to start the command again. Select this object. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, select the Move command. As a specifying base point prompt, select this area as a base point. Move the mouse cursor inside. Type 5 inches on your keyboard and press Enter. Now, go to the Quick Access toolbar and click the Match property. Select this Fisher board and select this one to change its properties. Go to the Quick Access toolbar and click the Save button. Right click into the drawing area, isolate and object isolation. This will bring all lines that you've been eyed recently. Now type join on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line, press enter. Press enter to start the command again. Select this line, press enter. Press enter to start the command again. Select this line and this line. Press enter. Now we need to create more Fisher book in this area. To do that, go to the hover your mouse cursor to the UCS, right click and select objects. Hover the mouse into select this line. Right click the UCS and select rotate axis, Y axis, and move the X axis in this direction. Right click again, rotate axis, X axis. Now rotate the Y axis to orient like this. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, tap one foot on the keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it down. Press escape to get out of the command. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit around this area. Go to the Home tab, draw panel, and select the polyline command. At the specified start point prompt, use the intersection object snap and snap into this area. Now move your mouse cursor and snap into this intersection. Press escape to get out of the panel. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the polyline command. At the specified start point prompt, click at this endpoint and move your mouse cursor down. Snap into this area. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 5 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Offset this line into this direction. Press escape. Now select this line and delete it. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Fillet this line to this line, this line to this line. Press escape. Select this line, right click, isolate object, hide object. Now go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the fillet command again. Select this line and this line. Type join on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line. Press enter. The line is already being joined. Select this line, go to the Home tab, Modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Move this line into the extrusion into this direction and type 1 inch. Press enter. Now select this object, use the move tool, and at the specifying base point prompt, click here for the base point. Now move into this direction and type 5 inches. Press enter. right click on the UCS and select object option. For the object, select this line. Now right click the UCS again, select rotate axis and X axis. Now move the Y into this direction, the Y axis into this direction. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 1 foot on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it down. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select these two lines, right click in the drawing area, isolate, isolate objects. Go to CAD, hide all the other objects except the two lines that you select. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. Select this endpoint and this endpoint. Press escape. Type J, join on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line, press enter. Select the line again, right click and select the polyline, close. Go to that, close the figure. Go to the home tab, modeling panel and select the extrude command. At the select object prompt, select this rectangle, press enter. At the specifying extrusion height, move the mouse cursor into the negative Z direction and type 1 inch, press enter. Select this solid, go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. Zoom in into this area. At the specifying place points, select this vertex. At the specifying X points only, move into the negative Z axis and type 5 inches. Press enter to get out of the command. Right click into the drawing area and hover the mouse cursor to isolate end object isolation. Go to that link, all the different objects that you've been using. Now, this object cross this other Fisher, but we will take care of them in a minute. Hold down your middle mouse button and orbit so that you have a better orientation of the model. Hover the mouse cursor to the UCS and right click, select world option. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 5 inches and press enter. Select this line and offset it inside. This line inside. This line inside. This line inside. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this solid, right click into the drawing area, isolate, hide objects. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 1 inch and press enter. Select this line and offset it inside. This line, offset it inside. This line, offset it inside. And this line offset it inside. Press escape to get out of the command. Now zoom in into this area and select this line. And zoom in into this area and select this line. Right click, isolate, isolate objects. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Type M for the multiple option and press enter. It took us still remember the previous radius. Fillet this line to this line, 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 this line to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 2 feet 6 inches, press enter. Offset this internal line inside. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this line and go to the home tab, click the down arrow after modify and select explode to explode this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the trim, click the down arrow and select the extend command. Zoom in into this area and select the external polyline, press enter. Now extend this line and this line and this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this line, and hit the delete key. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Type M for the multiple option. Select this line, fillet it to this line, this line, this line, to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and click the down arrow. Click the break command. Select this polyline and move your mouse cursor, click to break it into two. Press enter to repeat the command again. Click anywhere into this polyline and move to break it. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Go to the status bar and select the multiple option. Now fillet this line to this line, this line to this line. Fillet this line to this line, this line to this line. Press enter to get out of the command. Select this line, this polyline, right click, and hover the mouse cursor to polyline. Select the close option to close this cap. Again, to close this other cap, okay, this cap is already being closed. Select the two polyline, go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Move into the Z direction and type 1 foot on your keyboard. Press enter. Select the two objects, go to the layer panel, and move them to the fissure board layer. Press escape to get out of the command. Now right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. So we need to clean up this drawing to fitting our fissure board. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the box command. At the specified base point point, click on this corner. Now move the box approximately like this and move to the Z direction. Type 15 inches, press enter. Now go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the subtract command. Select this fissure board and press enter, and select this box, press enter. AutoCAD cut off this excess portion. Do the same thing for this. Go and select the box command, draw box from this corner, and move the mouse cursor past this point. Click move up or press enter. AutoCAD still remember the previous measurements. Now to trim off this excess, go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the subtract command. Select this fissure board, press enter, and select this, press enter to end the command. Again, we need to remove this extra fissure board here. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the box command. At the specified start point, from start from this vertex. Now move the box, click, press enter. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the subtract command. Select this fissure board, press enter, and select this box. Press enter to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the press pull command. Select this face, move into this area, and type 1 foot on your keyboard, press enter. Select this face again, move into this area, type 1 foot on your keyboard, press enter. Select this face, move and type 1 foot on your keyboard, press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as icon. Rename this drawing to 00 underscore 021D_DIAB and click the save button. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 5 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Offset this line 5 inches inside, this line 5 inches inside, this line 5 inches inside. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the break command. Select this line and break it into two portions. Press enter again to start the break command. Select this line and break it into two. Press enter to start the break command again. Hold down your shift key and orbit to get a better orientation. Break this line into two parts. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 1 inch on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it inside and select it again. Move inside and type 2 feet 6 inches, press enter. Select this line and offset it inside, then select it again. Move inside and type 2 feet 6 inches, press enter. Select this and offset it inside 1 inch, then select it. Move inside and type 2 feet 6 inches, press enter. Press enter to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command again. For the offset distance, type 1 inch, press enter. Select this line and offset it inside. Select this line and offset it inside. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the match property. At the prompt, select source object, select this fishable. At the select destination object prompt, select this and this object. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this object, right click and select similar. Right click, isolate, hide objects. Select this line, this polyline, and go to the home tab, modify panel, click the down arrow and select the exclude command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Zoom in into this area. Type M on your keyboard and press enter or select the multiple option on the status bar. Fillet this line to this line, 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 this line to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, drop panel and select the polyline command. I've got the mouse cursor into this area. Now move and type 1 inch, press enter. Move and use the perpendicular object snap and click on this area. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Type M for multiple and press enter. Fillet this line to this line, this line to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the offset, home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 1 inch and press enter. Offset this line inside and offset this line inside. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab and click the down arrow after the modify panel and select the break command. Break this line into two portions. Select the offset command again. Press enter, accept the 1 inch. Offset this line inside. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. At the prompt, select first object or type M on your keyboard and press enter. below this line, to this line, 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 this line, to this line. This line to this line, 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 this line to this line. Let's escape to get out of the command. Now go to the quick access toolbar and change the layer to Fisher Wood. Select these three lines, this polyline, and go to the Home tab, Modeling panel, and click the Extrude command. Move up and type 1 foot on your keyboard, press Enter, get out of the command. Now type Join on your keyboard, press Enter, select this line, these lines, hold down your Shift key and deselect if you select more than you plan. Select this line, this line, press Enter. Now go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Extrude command. Select this polyline, press Enter. Move your mouse cursor up and type 1 foot on your keyboard, press Enter. Go to the Quick Access toolbar and click the Save icon. Right click into the drawing layer, isolate End Object Isolation. Go to the Home tab, Layer panel, and click the down arrow on Isolate Objects. We'll get a little work to do here. That's okay. We're going to handle it in a minute. That's okay. Now go to the Home tab, Layer panel, and click the Isolate command. Select the roof and the Fisher board, press Enter. Now select this Fisher board, this Fisher board. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Move command. Click anywhere in the drawing area, move into the negative Z direction, and type 10.75 inches, press Enter. You see, the press pull that we did previously was a mistake. Since we know the amount that we pull, we can use the same command to press the same area again. All you need to do, go to the Home tab, Modeling panel, and select the press pull command. Select this face, zoom in and select this face. Move your mouse cursor in this direction and type 1 foot, press Enter to pull it back. Hold down your Shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Zoom in into this area around the mouse cursor. Move the cursor back and type 1 foot on your keyboard, press Enter. Do the same thing, hover the mouse cursor, move back and type 1 foot on your keyboard, press Enter. Press Escape to get out of the command. Alright, in this tutorial we learned the basic technique that you need to use to grade your Fisher book. In the next tutorial we're going to close all these gaps and try to subtract this Fisher board and grade the remaining Fisher board. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue on this series or any other tutorial on my channel, please click the subscribe button. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.